Students, if we can all please find our seats. Students, if we can all please find our seats.
Good morning, everyone. Oh, that's a hot microphone. I need to stand back. Good morning, everybody, and welcome. Thank you so very much for coming along to celebrate this wonderful occasion with us. We opened these doors in September 1923, but you're going to hear more about that in a moment. Special welcome. We've got some ladies here from the class of 1951. Welcome, ladies. Thank you so much for coming. And we also have a very special guest. We have a young lady here who's already registered, and she's the class of 2041. So Miss Saleh Butler, thank you for coming. I think she's up in the shade at the moment. I would like to now introduce you to Mr. Damien Delaney. Mr. Delaney has been teaching here for a number of years, and he is the Assistant Principal, Religious Identity and Mission. Thank you, Mr. Delaney.
Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Bishop Conaty, Our Lady of Loretto's Centenary Mass. It was 100 years and 1 month ago to this day, September 4th, 1923, that the doors of the first diocesan secondary school here on this campus officially opened. Founded by Bishop John Cantwell, Catholic Girls High School, as it was originally called, brought together for the first time the best and brightest teachers from various institutes of religious women. This was the realization of a vision began by Bishop Thomas Conaty. Fittingly, in 1955, the name of our school was changed to Bishop Conaty Memorial High School and would remain so until the merger with Our Lady of Loretto High School in 1989. Today, as we commemorate this solemn anniversary, we are honored with the presence of our Archbishop, Jose Gomez. We thank God for the past 100 years and pray for God's blessing upon our school that we will continue to serve the community and the church by educating women of faith, learning, responsibility, and vision for generations to come. Please now stand and sing our opening hymn as we begin our liturgy.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, peace be with you.
And with your spirit.
Very happy to be with all of you today for this special celebration of the 100th anniversary of Bishop Conaty Our Lady of Loretto High School. It is a moment of grace for all of us as we give thanks to God for these 100 years and ask especially for the present and future of the high school and all of the students in this beautiful school. So we offer the Mass especially for all of you and your families, and as I said before, to give thanks to God for this anniversary. So let's start a celebration acknowledging our sins and preparing ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask, Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy. Conformed to Christ in poverty and humility, grant that walking in Francis' footsteps, we may follow your Son, and through joyful charity, come to be united with you. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Lectura del libro de Nehemías. En el primer mes del año 20 del reinado de Atarjerjes, siendo yo, Nehemías, el copero mayor, serví una copa de vino y se la ofrecí al rey. Nunca me había presentado ante él con cara triste. Entonces el rey me preguntó, ¿por qué estás tan triste si no estás enfermo? ¿Qué es lo que te preocupa? Sentí entonces un gran temor y le respondí, que viva el rey para siempre. ¿Cómo no de estar triste cuando la ciudad donde se hayan enterrados mis padres está en ruinas y sus puertas consumidas por el fuego? El rey me dijo, ¿qué es, pues, lo que quieres? Me encomendé al Dios del cielo y le contesté al rey, Si le parece bien a mi señor, el rey, y si está satisfecho de mí, déjeme ir a Judá para reconstruir la ciudad donde están enterrados mis padres. El rey y la reina, que estaba sentado a su lado, me preguntaron, ¿cuánto durará tu viaje y cuándo volverás? Al rey le pareció bien el plazo que le indiqué y me permitió ir. Entonces yo añadí, ruego a mi señor, el rey, que me dé cartas para los gobernadores de la región del otro lado del río, para que me faciliten el viaje hasta Judá. Y una carta dirigida a Asaf, encargado de los bosques reales, para que me suministren madera para las puertas de la ciudadela del templo, para el muro de la ciudad y para la casa donde me voy a instalar. Gracias a Dios, el rey me concedió todo lo que le pedí. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
Reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke. As Jesus and his disciples were proceeding on their journey, someone said to him, "I will follow you wherever you go." Jesus answered him, "Foxes have dens, and birds of the sky have nests, but the Son of Man has nowhere to rest his head." To another he said, "Follow me." But he replied, "Let me go first and bury my father." But he answered him, "Let the dead bury their dead. But you, go and proclaim the kingdom of God." And another said, "I will follow you, Lord. But first, let me say farewell to my family at home." Jesus answered him, "No one who sets a hand to the plow and looks to what is left behind is fit for the kingdom of God." The Gospel of the Lord.
I want to take this book. At least we bring it back for this. No?
Yes.
Oh, no, I didn't. Yeah, it's okay. It's the other book.
My brothers and sisters in Christ, as I said, I'm very happy to be with all of you today for this special celebration of your anniversary. Let us praise God and let's thank him today for all his gifts and graces which he has poured out on this school during these past 100 years. I'm sorry that you have so much sun today. So we were praying that it will be a little cloudy today, but we were not lucky. So I tried to be brief in my homily. Was originally very long, but I'll do my best. So as I was reflecting on this anniversary, I was thinking about the many young women who discovered the path for their lives at this school, who met Jesus in this school and learned to walk in friendship with him for the rest of their lives. So we thank God today for the founders of this school. First, my predecessors, Archbishop John Canwell, Bishop Thomas Conaty, and also Cardinal McIntyre. We also want to thank God for the orders of women religious who serve as school spirituals and an academic heart, the Sisters of the Immaculate Heart of Mary, the Sisters of St. Joseph, the Sisters of Mercy, the Sisters of the Holy Cross, the Sisters of the Presentation, and the Sisters of Loretto. We are especially grateful to all the sisters for the dedication to this beautiful school. And also we thank God for the priests and the chaplains of the school throughout the years. So this is the beauty, it's a good day to really reflect on the beautiful purpose of Catholic education, to form disciples who will become leaders in every sector of our society, and who can change the world in the light of the beautiful teaching of Jesus Christ, using their knowledge and expertise guided by their faith. And the gospel today is good, first of all, because it was short, but also because it's a beautiful message. And it really comes to help us understand that our Catholic faith is calling us to follow Jesus Christ. And Jesus said in the gospel today, he says that to each one of us, "Follow me." Jesus wants us to build his kingdom with him, to spread his love everywhere, each in our own way. This is our purpose, our mission. And this is what we are here for. No matter where you are or what you end up doing for your livelihood, you may be a scientist or a teacher or an engineer or maybe working in a hospital and also raising kids, and maybe you become a women religious. No matter what, Jesus is calling you to follow him, my dear students. He's calling you to live according to his plan, to do his will with your life. And his will is that you become a saint and build his kingdom. So again, what Jesus says in the gospel, he says to all of us, to you and to me, he says, you go and proclaim the kingdom of God. And we do that in a normal way in our ordinary life, in our professions and vocations. But as we hear today, sometimes the people hesitate. They don't follow right away. They tell Jesus that they have things they want to take care of first. Obviously, Jesus understands. He knows that sometimes we get nervous, that we have doubts, that we get worried about things, about material things, about our future. We cannot be like to be in control. He understands our fears, but he tells us that we need to trust in him. Seek his kingdom first, and everything else will take care of itself. And that was especially beautiful in the life of St. Francis. Today, as you know, we celebrate the feast of St. Francis of Assisi. So we know that he was the son of a very wealthy man, and yet he gave up all his riches because he heard the voice of Jesus saying, follow me. And Jesus gave Francis a purpose. Francis was praying in an old chapel, and he heard Jesus telling him, build up my house, for it is nearly falling down. My dear brothers and sisters, this is our purpose. We are here to build up his house, to build up his church, to build his kingdom. And my dear young sisters, you are the generation of renewal. Jesus is expecting great things from you, exciting things. The world needs you. The church needs your leadership. St. John Paul II used to talk about the feminine genius, and it's really true. We need you to make a difference in our lives, with your lives and your faith. So, as for that grace to do something, so we ask for that grace that you are able in your lives to do something beautiful for Jesus. So, on this anniversary, let us renew our sense of purpose, our sense of mission. Let's make a new promise to stay close to Jesus, to follow him. Let us ask him every day, Lord, let me love you more and more. We can never be closer to Jesus than to meet him in the Holy Eucharist, as you know. So let's try to spend more time in his presence, in adoration, in going to Mass. Jesus is with us every single moment of our lives. And the more that we are aware of that, the more happy that we will be. Because with him, we can do everything and understand the beauty of our life and how we are all called to make a change in our daily lives. So, ask Mary, our Blessed Mother, in a special way. This month of October is the month of the Rosary, so maybe we have time to pray the Rosary. Just ask Mary, our Blessed Mother, for her intercession, that we will be faithful followers of our Lord Jesus Christ, and that he will be our best friend. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
My brothers and sisters, with St. Francis, let us give thanks and praise to God our Father, to our Lord Jesus Christ.
Our response is, Lord, hear our prayer. For Pope Francis, Archbishop Gomez, and all bishops, may the Lord give them the strength and courage to continue the work entrusted to St. Francis to bring about church reform and renewal. We pray it to the Lord.
Lord.
For our earth, that inspired by St. Francis, nations will protect and safeguard our environment and use its resources for the good of all. Lord, hear our prayer.
Lord, hear our prayer.
for our school community during the centenary year. May we continue to form women of faith, learning, responsibility, and vision who will become the salt of the earth and light of the world. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all alumni present at this liturgy, may God bless each according to their need. We pray to the Lord. For all of the deceased alumni and faculty of Bishop Conaty Memorial and Our Lady of Loretto High Schools, may they receive reward for their labors and share in the fullness of Christ's resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Father, hear the prayers of your people. Give us what you have inspired us to ask you for in faith. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we bring you these offerings, O Lord, we pray that we may be rightly disposed for the celebration of the mystery of the cross, which St. Francis so ardently embraced. Through Christ, our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, our Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God. For in the saints who consecrate themselves to Christ for the sake of the kingdom of heaven, it is right to celebrate the wonders of your providence, by which you call human nature back to its original holiness, and bring it to experience on this earth that gives you promise in the new world to come. As with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end, we acclaim. Fount of all holiness. May holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like dew falls, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us, worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we gather into one by the Holy Spirit.
Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jose, our Archbishop, and all the clergy.
Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ.
Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. And the same is command informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church. Graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof. Only said a word, my soul shall be healed. May the blood of Christ keep me safe for eternal life.
sit down. Let us pray. Grant us, we pray, O Lord, through these holy gifts we have received, that imitating the charity and apostolic seal of St. Francis, we may experience the effects of your love and spread them everywhere for the salvation of all. Through Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated.
I'm going to follow Archbishop Gomez's example and be very short because I know how hot it is right now for all of you, so thank you for your patience. But first and foremost, on behalf of the faculty, staff, administration of Bishop Conaty, Our Lady of Loretto High School, Archbishop Gomez, we just want to thank you sincerely for coming out today and blessing us with your presence. Your presence here has made this event all the more special and meaningful. Thank you so much. We're also very grateful for the two concelebrants this morning. Father Alexi Smith, who is he's our chaplain. He comes here once a month at least. He's always here for us. Thank you so much, Father Alexi. And also we have with us this morning Father Mario Torres, who is the pastor at St. Thomas the Apostle Church, our next door neighbor. So thank you so much, Father Mario. Because of the nature of this 100-year anniversary, it's a very special event. We were able to procure recognition from our Holy Father. So I would like to call forward our principal, Ms. Robin Carroll, who has worked tirelessly to put this program together and also to turn our school around. And I would like to quickly read to you, what is written on the blessing. The Holy Father Francis cordially imparts the requested apostolic blessing to Robin Carroll, principal, the students and staff of Bishop Conaty, Our Lady of Loretto High School, Archdiocese of Los Angeles, on the occasion of the 100th anniversary of the school, invoking through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary an abundance of divine graces, September 1st, 2023. Ms. Carroll, can you come forward, please? There she is. Second, I would like to call forward one of our faculty members who is celebrating a significant milestone this year. He's been at our school for 25 years, and in those 25 years, he's probably missed no more than 2 or 3 days in total. He's never sick, and he never calls in sick. So he's a true model of integrity in the workplace. Mr. Robert Lindsay, please come forward. Mr. Robert Lindsay. And Mr. Lindsay's certificate says, in this centennial year, recognizing 25 years of devoted service to Bishop Conaty, Our Lady of Loretto High School, presented to our Professor Robert Lindsay. And finally, we have one last recognition here this morning. When this young woman began working at Bishop Conaty, our Pope was Pope Paul VI, and our President was Richard Nixon. So this is her 50th year, and I'd like to read to you what Pope Francis gave to her. The Holy Father Francis cordially imparts the requested apostolic blessing to Janet Chambers, invoking through the intercession of the Blessed Virgin Mary an abundance of divine graces on behalf of her 50th anniversary. Congratulations, Ms. Chambers.
just one. We can just one, not as just one a memento, not as important as these ones, because these ones are from the Pope, but this one is from the Archdiocese of Los Angeles, so I just want to give this commemoration of this beautiful anniversary.
Thank you.
Nice. It's just for the
people.
You're welcome. Okay. Those ones are more important. So.
No, no.
Thank you. So before the final blessing, I just want to, again, congratulate all of you for this beautiful celebration of this 100th anniversary. As I said before, it's a moment of grace, and we give thanks to God for all of these 100 years and continue this extraordinary, beautiful ministry in the next 100 years at least. So you are in my praise in a special way, and I ask for your praise for my ministry here in the Archdiocese. I hope the message for today's celebration, it was wonderful, the Feast of St. Francis of Assisi. What a beautiful example for all of us to be a good, faithful follower of our Lord Jesus Christ. And the message of the gospel, just Jesus telling each one of us, follow me. And we do it, as I said before, we have the security of being absolutely blessed by God. So please stand for the final blessing. And make sure that you drink a lot of water after this Mass. So. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you in his kindness and pour out saving wisdom upon you. Amen.
Amen.
May he nourish you always with the teachings of the faith and may you persevere in holy deeds.
Amen. Amen.
May he turn yourselves toward himself and show you the path of charity and peace.
Amen.
And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit come down on you and remain with you forever.
Amen.
Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
Try.
At this time, we would invite our guests, alumni, and family members to head over to the gym for a small reception. Students, please be seated. I know it's hot, so you can remove your jacket. Round of applause for our choir.